Today on Alistair Art, we're going to be looking at the artwork of Paul Klee and his use of shape and color. Paul Klee was born on December 18th, 1879 in Mönchenbuchi, Switzerland, which is just north of Switzerland's capital city, Bern. Both of Paul's parents were musically talented. His father was a German music teacher who played multiple instruments, and his mother was a Swiss singer. Paul was musically gifted. He played the violin growing up, even had offers at the age of 11 to play for the city itself. In his teen years, he moved away from music because he liked the freedom that visual arts gave him. Paul later attended the Academy of Fine Arts in Munich, and after receiving his degree, he traveled around to Italy in 1901 and 1902, which had an everlasting effect on him artistically. A few years later, Klee married a Bavarian pianist named Lily Struff in 1906. They had one son together named Felix. Klee continued to work on his art and eventually had his first solo show in 1910. 1 year later, in 1911, Paul met other like-minded artists like August Mack, Franz Marc, and Wolseley Kandinsky. Kandinsky would be one of his friends for the rest of his life. He joined their artist group called Der Blue Rider, or the Blue Rider. They rejected what the elite said art was supposed to be. Paul later traveled in 1912 to Paris, where he was exposed to new art styles like Cubism and abstract art, which helped to inspire some of his more well-known artworks. 2 years later, he would complete his first purely abstract piece called In the Style of Kerhuar. In March of 1916, Paul was drafted by the Imperial German Army because his father was German. Luckily, he never actually was sent to the front lines. He had different jobs. One of them was actually repairing the camouflage on different types of vehicles. After the war had ended, is really when his artwork started to mature. In 1919, Klee began teaching at the Academy of Art in Stuttgart, later moving and teaching at the Bauhaus Art School from 1921 to 1931. But in 1923, Klee became a member of Die Blühen Vier, which was the Blue Four. Again, his really good friend Kandinsky was one of the artists, along with two others. They ended up lecturing and touring around the world. Life was really good for Klee until about 1933. In 1933, he was actually persecuted by the Nazis and he was forced to move back to Switzerland. In that same year, he started to suffer from a disease called scleroderma, which made life very difficult. He had almost stopped making art completely. In 1939, his health actually did recover a little bit, and he was visited by his really good friend Kandinsky and also Pablo Picasso, both of whom helped encourage him to keep making art. He made over 1,200 pieces just in 1939. Klee passed away on June 29, 1940, having made over 9,000 artworks in his lifetime and having helped inspire many artists and art movements like Expressionism, Cubism, Futurism, Surrealism, and Abstraction, or Abstract Art. Now, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be looking at two artworks in particular, Castle and Sun, and also City Picture with Red and Green Accents. The main materials you're going to be needing today to make your own artwork are a paper, pencil eraser, and possibly a ruler. You don't have to have a ruler, but it helps. You'll also need something to add some kind of color, so things like markers, crayons, colored pencils, or even watercolor paints work well. You can use other things as well. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just be using my pencil, eraser, and ruler, and I'm going to just make up the shapes that I want for my city. I'm going to be doing a city. So I'm going to be wanting some nice tall buildings, so I'm going to use my ruler. Remember, try to make sure that things are even when I look from the edge of the paper to the edge of my ruler at both the top and bottom, because we're just going to eyeball it. I can see that this is not going vertical. It's going more diagonal because it's small versus large. So to start making some of my tall buildings, I'm just going to make some nice big rectangles. And once I go and make a rectangle, I can always kind of cut that into smaller shapes, similar to the artwork that we looked at from Kandinsky. So if I want to maybe make some rectangles in here, maybe I want some skinny rectangles, maybe we want to try to make squares, things like that. Maybe I want to take some squares and actually cut them into triangles. We can do that as well. And we can also put different shapes up at the top of this as well. So if I want to go and make like a triangle on the top of this one, I can. I like to try to find about the middle, go up above it with a small dot, and then I can go down on both sides to make my triangle top. You can also add things like maybe we want to put circles in here. You could definitely trace things that are circle. You can freehand them. It's totally up to you. But try to add lots of little buildings. Or maybe if you want to make something like a big castle, you can. But again, try to do it with very simple shapes. So I'm going to go ahead and continue to draw mine out. And we'll make it go a little bit quicker for you, though. While you're drawing, try to take your time. I like to use my ruler or things that I can trace to try to make my shapes as nice and consistent as possible. When you're adding color, try to have fun with it. You can also try to think of different color theories to use. Like, do you want to use warm colors like red, orange, yellow? Do you want to use cool colors like greens, blues, and purples? Do you want to use complementary colors that are opposite of each other, triadic, that are all evenly spaced on the color wheel? Try to think of those kind of things. But whatever you're doing, please try to have fun with it. If you're not having fun, then you're doing your art the wrong way. This is supposed to be a good expression of you. And now that we're done coloring, here are some examples to look at. On this first example, I used watercolor paints. I did try to do a lot of warmer colors on one side and cooler colors on the other. And then on these other two, I used one with using crayons, where I used lots of different colors everywhere. And again, I tried to kind of separate warm and cooler colors when I did the colored pencil example here. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'd love to see you guys back. If you do make any artwork, please share it with me. You can also share them on Instagram. Just use the hashtag AlistairArt, and I will look at them. Thank you, guys.